Hello, my name is Jack Tuck, and this here is my little film thingy for autism awareness. As you can see, I do animation films with the Gary's Mod game, which is available on Steam on computers, not in pipes. But anyways, on to business. This here little video I have created for the autism awareness, to bring more awareness to a relatively unknown condition known as autism. Ironically, despite being unknown and barely mentioned, up to 700,000 people in the UK have this condition. So this little video here will explain the history of autism, and then finally, a little montage of what known conditions people have been noted to have with various conditions of autism, which will be mentioned, and hopefully get more people aware of this little trait of ours. So anyways, with the video. One thing that must be noted about autism is that it is not a newly discovered condition, but in fact has been around and notified since the early modern era of our history. The first discovered case of autism was made in France in 1797, with physician, French, it could be kind of bad here, Jean-Marc Gaspard Itard, with the case of Victor, the wild child of Avignon, a boy who lived alone in the woods near Saint-Cyrien-sur-Rance. It was here Itard taught the boy his social skills with social attachments and induced speech to him with imitation. The boy was believed to have shown an average degree of autism along with effects of mental derangement due to grown-up feral. Sadly, the wild child died in Paris in 1828. However, the word autism was not formally founded or used until 1910 when psychiatrist Paul Eugene Bleuler derived the word from the Greek word autos, meaning self, as he was defining conditions for schizophrenia. However, this never entered our public life until the 1930s and the 1940s. In Germany, Hans Asperger, which Asperger's syndrome is named after, which I have, by the by, first used the word as autistic psychopathy during his research on children's psychopathy. During his research, he noticed a pattern, notably a lack of empathy, little ability to form friendships, one-sided conversations, intense absorption in a special interest, and clumsy movements. He would call these children little professors because of their ability to talk about their favorite interests in detail. He investigated the life of one child, Fritz, into childhood, who would become a professor in astronomy, and solved an error in Newton's work he noticed as a child. Sadly, his works, even though groundbreaking at the time, never reached the public until 1981 due to several reasons. The Nazis were in control of Germany at the time, and due to their intolerance and disabilities, he never published his research. Due to the war with most of the Allied powers, most Allied nations simply ignored his work due to the fact he was being German. And finally, lack of translation. It was not until 1943 that another psychiatrist, the Austrian Leo Kanner, bring it to the public in his report, when he noticed 11 children with similar behavior similarities, notably autistic loneliness and insistence on sameness. His theories on autism were praised by the medical community and went on to be relatively unchallenged until the 60s, although today, due to advancements in medicinal and psychological analysis, some theories have changed, but it largely remains unchanged and lingered into the 21st century. Well, there you are, a little brief history on the story of autism. There is much more to talk about with the topic. I highly recommend reading more on the topic from such books such as The Autistic Brain, 9 Degrees of Autism, the medical journals, and the Understanding Autism for Dummies. Okay, to end this video, I have produced a montage using my animations to show the viewers on the known traits of autism. Hopefully, it shall be as entertaining as it is educational. Enjoy.
You are no match for me!
What? Mine!
Soldier! Here!
Hmm. your lumps like a man, Private Quinn.
Soldier!
No!
Thanks for watching this featured presentation, and so long.